Good morning students. So today we will do exercise A and B of chapter 8, that is animal reproduction, and exercise is given at page number 65 in your book. So exercise A is tick the correct option. In this question, some questions are given to you and along with it 4 options are given from which you have to tick on the correct answer. So let's start. Question 1 is, the yellow portion inside the egg is called. So student, when we have discussed about or when we have read about the structure of the egg, we have discussed that there are 3 layers. The outermost layer, which is known as the eggshell, it is a protective covering. Below to this, there is a white color substance, jelly-like substance, which is known as the albumin. And below the albumin, there is a yellow color substance which is known as the yolk, and it provides the nutrition to the developing embryo. So options are given: A is albumen, B is yolk, C is shell, and D is embryo. So option B, yolk, is the correct answer of this question 1. Next, question 2 is, an egg has a thin protective covering called the. Options are given: A, pupa, B, albumen, C, yolk, and D is eggshell. So student, as we have discussed, that the structure of egg consists of 3 layers. Outermost thin protective covering, which is known as eggshell. Below to this, albumen, and a yellow color substance which is known as the yolk. In this, options are given: pupa, it is the resting phase of the insect life cycle. Albumen is the white color substance. It contains 40 different types of proteins. Yolk is the yellow color substance which provides nourishment or nutrition to the developing embryo. And D option, eggshell, is the outermost thin protecting covering that provides protection to the embryo and the inner part of the egg. Next, question 3 is, the following animals does not reproduce by laying eggs. So in this question, student, you have to tick on the animal that do not reproduce by laying eggs. So options are given: A is grasshopper, B is cockroach, C is rabbit, and D is fish. So when we have discussed about the 2 ways by which the animals reproduce, first by laying eggs, which are known as oviparous animal, and the second is the animal that give birth to babies, which are known as viviparous animal. And the another term we have discussed about this, these are also known as mammals because they give birth to babies which are similar to them and also feed their young babies with their own milk. And the examples of the mammals are cat, dog, human beings, dog, horse, and rabbit. So in this, options are given: grasshopper, it reproduces by laying eggs. Cockroach also reproduces by laying eggs. Rabbit, C, it give birth to babies of their own kind. So this C is the correct answer of this question 3. And fish also reproduce large number of eggs in water. So C is the correct answer of this question 3. Next, question 4 is, the process of shedding of old skin by the animal is called. Options are given: A is molting, B is metamorphosis, C is life cycle, and D is incubation. So student, when we have discussed about this, we have read that when we have discussed about the life cycle of butterfly, we have discussed that it lays the egg, then from the egg, after following the process of incubation, the worm-like structure hatches out, which are known as the larva. It is known as the caterpillar, and from the this caterpillar forms a protective covering around it, which is known as the pupa stage. And then this pupa sheds its skin many times and then finally forms a adult butterfly. And this process of shedding of old skin is known as the molting. So options are given: A is molting, this is the correct answer. B, metamorphosis. But it is a process which is followed by the young ones which are not similar to their parents. It is the process in which the young ones are not identical to their parents. So they undergo transformation so that they will become similar to their parents, and it is shown generally followed by the frogs. Life cycle, it is the stages from larval stage to the adult of an organism. So these are the different stages which are followed by an organism. And incubation means to warm up the eggs by either keeping them in a warm place or by sitting on them by the parent So answer A is the option A is the correct answer of this question for mounting. Next fifth one is which of the following is not a mammal? So student in this question you have to tick on the option out of which of the following is not a mammal. So options are given A is bat, B is lion, C is human and D is frog. So as we have discussed that bat is a mammal that can fly. B, lion is also a terrestrial mammal that give birth to babies and feed their young babies with their own milk. C, human is also a mammal and they also give birth to babies of their own kind. And D, frog is an amphibian and it lay eggs. So frog is not a mammal. So D is the correct answer of this question D. So next we will discuss about the exercise B. So student, now exercise B is true or false. This exercise is also given at page number 65 in your book. So statements are given. First statement is animal reproduce only by laying eggs. So this statement is false because as we have discussed animals reproduce by two ways. First by laying eggs, another way is they produce young babies of their own kind. So this statement is false. So we will write F in this statement. So next question 2 is all birds reproduce by laying eggs. So as we have discussed the bird like hen, eagle, they reproduce by laying eggs only. So this statement is true. So we will write T for this statement. Next statement 3 is the white jelly-like substance in an egg is called the albumin. So when we have discussed about the structure of egg, we have learned that the outermost covering, thin protecting covering is known as the eggshell that protects the inner content of the egg. After that, we have discussed there is a white jelly-like substance which is known as the albumin. And it is talked about this only that white jelly-like substance is called the albumin. This statement is true. So we will write T here for this correct statement. Next. Statement 4th is a butterfly shed its skin and forms a pupa. So student, this statement is false because when we have discussed about the life cycle of butterfly, we have discussed that the butterfly lay its egg on the leaf. After that, from the egg, after following the process of incubation and hatching is followed, then from the eggs, the small worm-like structures comes out which is known as the caterpillar. Then the caterpillar forms a protective covering around it is known as the pupa. And it is given a butterfly shed its skin. Butterfly apni skin shed karta hai, then pupa banata hai. The statement is false. So we will write F for this. Generally what happens, the caterpillar forms a protecting covering around itself and then the pupa is formed. After this, fifth statement is given, snakes and lizard lay their eggs on the trees. So student, snakes and lizard, snake is a reptile, lizard also a reptile, they lay their eggs on the ground. So this statement is false. So we will write F for this statement. So student, this is all about your exercise A and B. Thank you and have a nice day.